Hi, Ponder. Are you feeling all right? I'm sick, and I'm weaning off medication right now that is making my weed, instead of relieving my anxiety, it makes it worse. So, like, that's a thing. But whatever. I figured people sent me a zillion things to look over, and I so could not fucking be arsed that I was like, you know what? Why don't I just turn it into a research stream and we can all have some fun? I also apologize if my voice is a little bleh. I have le COVID, and my most prominent symptom seems to be my voice being a bitch. rip to that. But today seems to be an all right-ish day. It's much better than the last 2 days have been. Still not good enough to record, but hey, I could probably talk to you guys for a couple hours. Okay, so let's see. So for anyone who doesn't follow me on Twitter, last night I was vague tweeting about a blog that I did a research stream on about a year ago, where, I went over their quote-unquote evidence archive and I thought it was garbage, and they were all like, "Oh, well, we'll reorganize things and then you can come back." They didn't do that. Another commentator looked at this stuff a year later, had a bunch of similar criticisms that I had, and the person who was like running the blog basically just kept saying, "Hey, this person is a pedophile and a groomer. I have proof. I'm going over it. You just have to trust me and wait until I'm done," for months and months and months and months and months. And eventually they just decided, "Hey, running this blog is too mentally tasking for me. I'm gonna leave. But I'm gonna leave the blog up." That same commentator then heard about accusations against the blog runner, and after multiple attempts of trying to contact them with no success, point is, someone was saying, "Hey, this person is a groomer and a pedophile, I have proof," and then they were not showcasing the proof, and I was, vaguing about how dumb that is. Yeah, I tweet out, "Hey, this person is a groomer and a pedo. I have proof. Someone else, none of this is proof. I'm still going over the real proof, but it's mentally draining, so I'm not gonna finish slash post it. Oh, so I found these accusations about you. Let me just delete everything," because the blog is now fucking gone. So, Fennekin Draws then comments, "I hate it when dumbass people decide to claim someone is either a pedo or in a CP ring with little to no evidence other than, like, art style or something. And then when they get called out for it, delete all the evidence accusations like that are serious and shouldn't be slung." Which I do agree with this. Oh, do you not read stream comments? The fuck's up, Blipple. Ugh. "It's a terrible idea to do a research stream on Kenji." Why? Because he wants attention? Why does that matter? Can you DM me? Ugh. All right. Tweet at me real quick so I know it's you. There. Go for it. Tell us why we should not give this any attention, despite the fact that I'm now so fucking intrigued and people have given me so much shit to go over, but I'm also simultaneously not supposed to pay attention to it. Either you want me to go over this shit or I shouldn't go over this shit. It's one or the other. And to be fair, if that's the case, I have more issues with the original comment that I took issue with, talking about it and like bringing up the stash. I need to know. Tell me. I have to understand. I'm so curious. Tell me all the things, Pips. Otherwise, I'ma just go into this shit. Alright, sorry, blah blah blah. Try to keep it. The group is Crystally Supporter Group, KVA. It's been around since 2020, and they're a group of attention seekers who harass the victims, and Kenji's a part of it. They poke reactions out of everyone for attention and laugh about it in their group chat. I fail to see why this is something I should not pay attention to. The girl who tweeted the stash out about Kenji is definitely lackluster. They mustn't get any attention there. I have to be reading that wrong, because, like, the way that sounds, it sounds like the person who tweeted out the stash, or maybe the person who made the stash, are also a part of the group, which just sounds really stupid. "We've been working behind the scenes to get rid of them without giving them attention." Okay, so who is this Kuromi Batwings person that, like, tweeted out the fucking stash? Kuromi, I believe, is one of the people or friends with one of the people who is attacked by. So, yeah, I assume the friend is the person who made the stash. Happy Soft LTDs. She runs an Instagram against them. No idea why she tweeted out at you, but yeah, that's the girl who runs the anti-KVA account and is a victim. I can link you Kenji's account. I mean, I know Kenji's account. It's the Fennekin Draws one, supposedly. "Can you not just like talk it out first before jumping into this and ruining all our work we've done for years?" I fail to see how looking into this. How does this ruin your work? I'm not delving into it. I'm just talking about what got me interested, Blipple. I mean, if you can, like, immediately tell me how talking about this is going to ruin your efforts, I will gladly stop the stream or talk about something else, or I don't know, maybe flip into art. Okay, But Blipple, what is the downside of giving them attention? Like, what will happen if I look over this that will negative, like, what negative effect will arise from me looking over this? The downside is them becoming relevant again and hyping them up to keep. So, literally, just the argument of you're feeding the troll. Hey guys, here I am currently acknowledging that this is a troll and they apparently thrive off of people's bad reactions to them. So, don't give it. Just enjoy the stream. Nobody has presented me with any like downside to looking into this other than you'll make them think they're relevant, which I would argue they probably already think that since Kuromi was tweeting about it. So, all right, so who wants to look into this? So normally we would be able to agree with what this Fennekindraws person says. You shouldn't be throwing out serious accusations online if you can't fucking back it up. And sometimes even if you can't, or even if you think you can back it up, don't, 'cause you're probably dumb. Normally we would agree with them, although you can note that Fennekin is clearly referencing something specific because people don't tend to accuse people of being in CP rings. That's a very specific thing. And then we get this message from Kuromi Batwings, followed up with a couple of replies. So the first message is a stash link, which we'll go over in a sec, and the message replies say, "It's because you did actually do it and made a bullshit call-out post on the people who blew the whistle on your behavior instead of making an actual response." So basically, Kuromi Batwings is directly implying that, like, being a pedo and being in a CP ring were actually things that Fennekindraws did. And I suppose the stash link is supposed to be their proof on that, because otherwise, why the fuck else would you post it if it was completely unrelated? Let's look at that, shall we? Kenji lied to us all. Kenji runs the Cream Paws the Wolf account and is involved with a pedophile cult slash CP ring, all while being 18 years old. Interesting. Oh, Cristalli. So, for people who don't know, Cristalli was actually someone who was preying on kids and did get arrested. He ended up out of jail, but in like an area where nobody fucking likes child predators. For some fucking reason, Cristalli's still got fans. Pretty sure most of those fans at this point are trolls. Cream Paws, hair shading. Making this one of my first points because it's one of the most obvious to me. Note the strange gradient, the harsh white line followed by a gradient to the base color and then a gradient to the shade color. Oh, so just like stupid fucking repetitive gradient fade. Kenji's hair shading. Would you look at that? A harsh highlight with a lower opacity white, a gradient to the base color. I think that should be then, not than. Gradient to shade. All done in it. Yes, we get it. It looks the same. Bloody Paws hair shading. Very soft. Either a lighter shade of the base color and not a harsh white or no highlights at all. I think that's supposed to be or only a shadow, but whatever. Next one. So there's no additional description stuff to fill us in on like any other stuff. So let's take a short look at this account feed. I want to show you a very small detail that is incredibly damning in my opinion. Let's look at these two posts. The image quality of is pretty The image quality of this post is pretty much the standard Instagram quality. Most likely, this is the original file simply posted to this account. And I say that because this post, which contains Paws' actual art, is incredibly low quality, most likely taken from a website which displays a separate image What the fuck does this have to do with anything? These three are bullshit and I don't care. Okay, next. Number four. Oh no. Simplicity of design and lack thereof. I would argue a bunch of these designs aren't that simple. Especially this one. This is very busy. Kenji's character designs are often overcomplicated. They contain a lot of muddy colors and a severe mismatching of patterns, often to a headache-inducing degree. There is often a use of some form of pattern in his adopt designs. I assume this is just to, like, point out what Kenji's designs look like. When Paws posted Adopt Stolen or Not, they would often use very simplified designs. Wait, what? I don't even know what the fuck is supposed to be being proven here. According to Blip, they're saying these two are, they're trying to prove these two are the same via art style and that we are brain dead for not seeing this. The issue is, my ex is a very similar. Wait. So they're trying to prove it's the same person? Yeah, the stash is really horribly done, which is why I was like, why was this linked? Why was this the thing that somebody linked when they mentioned pedos and CP rings? I don't understand. What? Ah! Like, you'd think if you were gonna call someone out publicly on someone else's thread, you'd like have the shit ready. Notice the overcomplicating in the outfits of Cream Paws adopts as compared to the simple outfits in Paws' designs and the overcomplicated outfits of Kenji's. Oh, that was it? Just, hey, notice this thing? I can't even tell whose art is fucking whose. Okay, so this is Kenji's art. We got them tall bitches. Overcomplicated, got it. Oh, and Paz also traced your artwork. Where's that? Oh my god. Okay, whatever. Part two. What is this cover? Kenji's quote-unquote apology. I'd take it with a grain of salt when it comes to the account being multiple people. Kenji, as we see, is a compulsive liar. What do you mean, as we see? Or as we will see? I better see that. So, Lavender adopts. Supposedly, Kenji says, the original account was meant to be me, Toxic, and two other people dedicated to getting information on white wolves to report to the police. If you don't want to admit art style can be a big help to detecting people you're insanely wrong, I've caught multiple people based off... Nobody's saying that catching someone via their art style isn't possible, but like, I literally can't tell what the fuck is what here. If someone can present me with some better presented whatever. Yes, so normally I would expect someone to like say something about this first part of this quote-unquote apology, which seems like it's in direct contrast with, like, everything Kenji's being accused of. But we'll see. The account was dedicated to blending in. I posted, like, several traces of my own artwork dedicated to trying and blend in for evidence. The account got out of hand. While I didn't inherently trace the piece, I did allow it to be uploaded. I'm sorry. I left the account a while ago because I realized as soon as people started attacking it due to traces, I didn't put that... I didn't want to be involved in the situation, nor did I have the balls to be involved. While I did say stuff in that GC to blend in, I didn't mean it. Multiple of the people in the account also said stuff, but I don't know what they said. I left the account after realizing I didn't want to be involved. I'd rather sit playing games than sit answering to shit like that. And for some reason, this other one is just the same thing, but again.
You commented in the reply thread. Oh, okay.
So the point of the stash was to compare Kenji's normal art to his art on his Cream Paws account. So this was the Cream Paws account. I mean, yeah, I feel like these are probably done by the same person, but I'm mostly looking at, like, the line tool and how fucking shaky the lines are. Cause, like, yeah, sometimes you can't hide that shit, bro. So, yeah, I could probably agree that, like, these two are done by the same person. If he was stealing designs to be a troll, who cares? Oh no! Sent in by an anonymous source. Oh, I don't like that. Don't trust anonymous sources. So, we got Cream Paws the Wolf, we got Strawberry Skies. Oh, that's it, okay. Cream Paws says, Raz is funny, lol. Strawberry says, she's so fat, you should see her IRL pics. There are literal stains on her clothes and in her mirror. Cream Paws says, I've seen them. They made fun of me for being slightly overweight, but bitch looks like a whale. Strawberry Skies, damn, has Raz even looked in the mirror? LMFAO, she dresses up like a fourth grader to look sexy and she's nearly 30. People just being mean for the sake of being mean, basically. Kenji, I'll admit, is the only person who I've made fun of. I question why this screenshot is here, because, like, you would think the screenshot is here to showcase that Kenji is, like, mean and says mean things about people behind the scenes. But then, immediately after, we have Happy, the person who made the stash, admitting that they also made fun of Kenji for his weight. Like, I don't care if you did it because of his bad behavior, you were making fun of somebody's physical appearance. Kenji could argue, like, oh, I was also making fun of her physical appearance because she made fun of mine. Like, does it justify it? No. But, like, depending on Kenji's age, I'm not fucking surprised. That's another thing, I want to know exactly how fucking old everybody is. Pretty sure Happy is 16 currently, which, like, begs the question, how long have you been going at this? Honey, go do something better with your life. Oh my god. Just go be a happy little 16-year-old. Things went quiet for a few days until a new account surfaced, re-uploading posts from the old account. Fruit Loop Milk, who cares? All of the followers are members of KVA. KVA is a CP ring and cult dedicated to worshipping pedophiles. Oh wow, that's a sentence. How many more screenshots do we have? Oh, two? Okay. I question whether there's ever gonna be any attempt to prove the CP ring thing, cause oh my god. So, this was Kenji's response, I guess. It's a friend of mine, I gave them all of the art that was a part of the old account and told them to do whatever with it. They're getting screenshots of Toxic since they made a new account and are part of a KVA group chat. I refuse to get involved in their Instagram issues. So you're allowing your friend to continue on your your interactions with the pedophilic cult and your support in that. I'm not supporting it. I said do whatever you want with this. I'm not supporting it. You provided them with all the stuff they needed, so yes, you are. I would agree with that. That's just fucking... I'm not supporting it. I just gave them everything they need. Hey, 16-year-old, instead of accusing strangers online for obscene crimes with lukewarm evidence, how about you write a cringy fanfic of your OC like a normal teenager? Yeah, it's probably way more fun and way less mentally draining, too. The account has also traced Kuromi Batwings, who Kenji has been stealing, copying designs from, as well as tracing. Kenji has a history of tracing and copying people who he is mad at or being called out by. Conclusion. Oh. If your call-out uses things like was or dog or I don't give a fuck, stop. Just stop. Go outside and play. Go play soccer. Go play with your Barbie dolls. You're too fucking young for this shit. Oh my god. I was gonna make a more in-depth series of posts regarding your history, but you know what, dog? I don't give a fuck. I mean, apparently you do in instances where I ask you to prove your stance and your accusations, because, like, yeah, the 16-year-old's actively been kind of upset in my comments because I've been questioning this. Don't be mad at her. She's obviously just, like, freaking out because I'm questioning something that they are, I guess, convinced is true. But, like, if you're gonna get this upset when somebody questions the serious accusations you're throwing out, you shouldn't be throwing out serious accusations. You're not mentally well enough for it. Oh my god. Go play outside.
You can't see me, but I'm holding up my hands here. Pedo ring? Tracer. One of these things is more important than the other, and I feel like putting more emphasis on the second one should maybe take a backseat.
Once you start saying, hey, this person's in a pedo ring, I don't give a single fuck if they're tracing your artwork. Bitch, I don't care. Show me the proof of the pedo ring.
If you want to add that as just like, and also, sure. But that better be an and also, not a, so this is what I'm starting with.
Okay, so I basically called out Kuromi Batwings with another tweet saying, not somebody linking a DA stash call out accusing someone of being in a pedo cult with zero heckin' evidence in the same post where I'm complaining about people doing that very thing. So then Kuromi was like, oh my god, won't, no wait, I have to show all of the real evidence because of course, like that just doesn't fucking prove my point. Like, if you're gonna be throwing out accusations, have the good shit be what you're throwing out. Don't throw around fucking, oh, they traced the art. So Blipple sent me another couple messages. Oh god, Blipple sent me a lot more messages, actually, since I last checked. Oh goodness. Yes, the point of Stash was to compare the artwork, blah blah blah. I got what happened from Happy Soft. Kenji tweeted out to you this, happy friend responded with a stash against Kenji because they thought it was funny how hypocritical Kenji sounded because Kenji has been called out multiple times in relationship to their art style as Primrose draws, etc. Even in your Nora research stream, you went over one of Kenji's accounts. They've been doing this since forever. Y'all expect me to remember a lot. People be all like, oh, Primrose draws, Ponder already knows them, and I'm like, I don't remember. Like, y'all expect me to remember a lot of shit. I definitely do not remember shit that I just go over in research streams. Happy made the stash for her followers, an anti-KVA account, for people who fully knew of KVA and Kenji, so that's why the context is so confusing to an outsider. She didn't tweet the stash for you to review, she tweeted it at Kenji out of them. Yeah, I don't care if you're gonna be tweeting out public accusations, like, whatever you're tweeting has to fucking be relevant. You can't be all like, oh, pedo ring and CP cult, and then tweet the shit about tracing art. Though I think it's obvious is Kenji's, yeah, we don't care. Kenji's cream paws. Okay, so now we've got screenshots. Oh, and a lot. Looks like they deleted their account today after Happy made the tweet, but yeah, we didn't want KVA to get attention because every time they get it, they do worse and worse stuff. Now I've got a message from Blipple that says, they groom children for attention. The group groomed a 12-year-old, one of the girls groomed multiple kids for attention, so every time they get attention, they get worse and worse with their approaches. That's why we didn't want them to be in the spotlight and have kept it on the down low for so long. Now we've got another fucking accusation, and it's not just that this is a pedo ring and that these people are pedophiles and that they have CP. Now it's that they've groomed kids. So now I want to see the fucking grooming accusations and find the evidence for that. Because, like, I'm not saying it's impossible that it happened, but I am very skeptical. Mostly because people lie all the fucking time. And about shit you wouldn't expect them to half the time. I don't trust randos that I don't know. Let's go over the other stuff that blah 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 sent me. Kuromi. Okay, so then they linked me to this, which was a thread from 2020. Harassment, doxing, stalking, CP mention. Primrose Draws has done some fucked up things, including drawing and admitting to accessing CP. I've already sort of seen a thing. We'll go over it. Stalking a user known as Blood Orange. Falsely accusing people of spreading nudes. Harassing people who prove them wrong more. Pretending to be a pedophile.
Pretending?
I'm sorry? I feel the need to make note that the first fucking thread that Kuromi sent me is now contradicting the whole pedophile thing with, like, oh, they were pretending to be a pedophile. So you know that it was for pretend.
Rosemary the Witchy says police were contacted multiple times. Either nothing happened or they let them off with a warning or slap on the wrist.
Okay, so we got some posts.
If they're pretending, then is no one getting actually hurt? Like, or is it all? Or is everyone in on it?
Well, no. I think the implication is that they're pretending to be a pedophile, but in pretending to be a pedophile, they actually did groom children. Like, they were trolling, but the trolling ended up in grooming. Which, again, I haven't seen the evidence for, so I'm like, okay. What? I don't know how somebody trolls so hard that they turn themselves into a child groomer.
Rosemary says, we tried to stop it so many times, contacted the victims, tried reaching out to parents and more, we were trying to stop it. Didn't you just try to shut Ponder up about the situation?
No, they, because they didn't want me to talk about it, the fear that, like, the group would become relevant again and abuse more kids. But, like, I don't even understand the avenue by which they've abused kids. I still want to see that. To be fair, Burnish Winks, sometimes there is stuff, just the police can be awful. Depending on where the people live, the police may or may not be able to do anything.
I have absolutely no doubt in my mind the police were fucking useless in it.
Blipple, we haven't actually seen any evidence that someone has been groomed. So yes, we are questioning that claim, because we haven't seen anything to prove it. So, I literally just got done saying we haven't seen any evidence of grooming. I messaged you the at of the mom and the daughter. Oh, more ads, okay. Okay, Blipple, I'm not going to the victim. If this person actually is a victim, I'm not going up to them and say, hey, prove to me, this random fucker that you don't know, that you were groomed. No! I'm asking the people who are going around in public spaces saying this shit. Because if they're gonna be going around saying this shit, they need the fucking evidence! If you don't have the evidence, I'm sorry. Even if it happened, you can't just go around saying shit. It creates a horrible goddamn precedent because bad actors use that shit all the goddamn time. Plus, how can they have groomed a child for attention? That begs the question, like, were people aware they groomed the child and they were using it to, like, draw more kids in? Like, how did this fucking happen? And no, I'm not going to the victim. Oh my god. Or the alleged victim. I'm not gonna go confront them. Kenji harassed me for years, including stealing slash tracing my art, accusing me of stealing from them, lying to YouTubers in the hopes they'd expose me for stuff they made up, and harassing my then BF and friends several times. There's so much stuff with- If somebody harasses you for years, yes, that sucks, I'm sorry that happened to you, but they're trolls. Blipple has even fucking acknowledged they're trolls and they do it for attention, so anytime you were freaking out because they were tracing your artwork, according to Blipple, you were just giving them the attention and the reaction that they wanted. I just want proof. For the criminal acts. That's it. If you're going around being all like, this person's a pedo and in a CP ring, that's the evidence I want to see. I don't want to see shit regarding, oh, this person is also this user and they traced my art. I don't care. Zero fucking shits given about traced art. Okay, I'm not watching this video because this is fucking Primrose Draws as a tracer. I don't care. Harley's video.
Hello everyone, I'm Orange, an Orange Queen, and when it comes to the drama, I'm pretty much the main person who's had to deal with Rose the longest.
So this is the person that was being stalked by Primrose, I think? There's a lot of stuff to go over. So
about her, it's just, she's victim complex, the person. As in, whenever she gets called out on anything, like tracing, harassing people, doxing people, being transphobic, etc., she will always-
I wanna look at these. Prim, seriously, you can just fucking stop being a childish girl. Said by Cloudship. And then, Soda Kazuichi. You know I have trauma and go as far as to make fun of it? Lavin, LMAO, the asexual cut, rude.
Jesus have mercy. I feel like I should be clutching my pearls right now, but what the fuck?
Oh, okay. Goodness. He said, his last name too. Yeah, blank. He also showed what school he goes to. If you want to see a person with no friends, look in the mirror. I'm not saying that. Thanks, human. Rose, this is low even for you. Trans, stick together, stop. And being transphobic, acknowledging. That's something that's always weird. If someone is being homophobic or transphobic or racist for the sake of, like, trolling, like, they're still being homophobic, transphobic, and racist.
Yeah, like, they know why those words are bad.
They're just like, oh, I'm just trying to get
a reaction.
If it's a reaction to, like, you know, bigotry, they don't know how trolling works.
Make up big screenshots just to get other users harassed. And a good example of this is in her own video about me, where she talks in third person to sound like I've been in more drama with more people than her. It's just really sad, honestly. She also lies all the fucking time. Like, she's known for it, and this isn't even like a recent thing. Back in 2018, when I was on her old server, she was just saying this dude at her old school called Aaron was stealing her YouTube videos and her art. But then a few months later, in one of her videos, she accidentally showed a list of the lost emails she'd logged into, and his was there. She'd been stealing all his stuff just for pity. An example of this would be her spreading around that I sent her quote unquote nudes to people when she was 14 in 2017.
Oh, okay. So Primrose claimed that Orange here, I guess, took her nudes? Damn, okay. Oh, so that must be the allegation of falsely accusing people of spreading nudes. Okay.
Is in August, and I met her around mid-July, and it's already been debunked a few times that it was her ex-fox who spread around this pic of her in, like, an old lady bra, and I wasn't the only person she accused of doing that, by the way. She also accused her other ex, Eric.
The just Eric. That bitch tried framing me for releasing her news and said I hacked her to get- I'm sorry. I'll give Orange the benefit of the doubt in believing, like, sure, maybe Primrose was going around saying this, but why is your fucking evidence for this someone else saying it happened? Harley, the fact that this was in your video, I'm so upset. And this is from 2019? This is from January 18th, 2019, which again makes me wonder how old Primrose was, because I'm under the impression that Primrose is, like, currently 18, so 3 years ago she would have been 15? Or 16, maybe?
We don't want to actually see the news, but we want more evidence than what we're seeing here.
We want at least evidence that Kenji, or Primrose, I guess, at the time, was going around saying it. Not Primrose's ex saying, hey, she totally went around saying this. Like, show us where she was going around saying it! This is he said, she said, and this is not what evidence is. Also, again, is Primrose 15 or 16? Here, I want to know how old everybody is.
That always seems to be the one thing that everyone cuts out.
Yeah, because half the time they know if they included the age, like, their arguments would fall flat.
Around, which no surprise, she also blamed me for.
Everyone, blank road, blah, UK, first house on the street, blank. That's the house of a known pedophile and a piece of shit. Have fun. Okay. I'm not gonna deny that it's possible that Primrose said these things. I'm gonna be real. Like, I got done saying it earlier. People lie about dumb shit all the time, and they lie about shit you don't expect them to. So yeah, I would totally believe that some random 16-year-old, just for the sake of wanting attention, was like, hey, my ex leaked my nudes. But, like, I still need to see evidence of it. I can't just have the ex say that it happened.
On the topic of doxing, she's been accusing me of it a lot lately. In her proof is a screenshot of me posting a house in a group chat that Eric sent me without context. And he was active in the group chat, so I sent it in there to ask about it. But in hindsight, it probably wasn't a good idea, because now I have Rose whining about it, even though she's doxed several people, including her ex-boyfriend Ian, my boyfriend Menace.
Well, that was very fast! Primrose Draws, 2018, so... Wait, so this is even farther back? In this screenshot, is she 15 or 14? And this is September, so... Her birthday's in August, so this would be just after she turned 15? Is that what this is? Primrose would be 15. Yeah, so Primrose was 15. Again, shouldn't be doxing people, but Cherry Blossom Tree sent me a pic of you and your boyfriend. Y'all, what? Blank, real name, just stop. Okay, what's his address then? Don't publicly give it someone's name. Okay.
My boyfriend Menace.
Also, great job adding more drama to the Nora bullshit. Kind of makes you a stalker, Prim. Blank shopping center. Nope, he moved. Actually, no, someone just told me this info via DMs. So is either Cherry Blossom Tree is Prim, or they're referencing something that Prim sent to them. Yeah, blank shopping mall center. Oof, he goes to blank university.
The little censored bit is my IP address.
Like, are we supposed to know who any of these people are? Cherry Blossom is Prim. Thank you for the confirmation. That would have been so nice for it to have been included in the original fucking video. This is why whenever I go over shit where there's, like, multiple people or they have, like, multiple names, you have to go over all their different names and you have to use one name throughout the whole thing so it's easy to figure out who everybody is. Yeah, I'm not even gonna fucking comment on, like, the fact that half of these things aren't dated properly so we can't trust.
Yes. And she's trying to DDoS me, and a little censored bit is my IP address. This brings us to today, where she's now claiming that I'm a homophobic groomer who manipulates kids. And if that sounds like an overstatement of what she said, it's really not. And if you're like, well, Orange, why is she calling you that? I'm pretty sure it's because Rose wants all of the bad attention off of her. She's one of the most manipulative people I've ever seen.
Who the fuck are these people? Oh my god! What does any of this have to do with anything? Menace deserves better. Okay, so that's the Menace mentioned earlier. Menace loves her though. He got her a necklace with a speck of diamond in it, I think. I'm very good at manipulation and ruining relationships, especially my own. Don't try me. Why are the screenshots up for like 0.5 seconds? Yeah, and why are they not read out? I can't fucking stand when videos are like, oh, here's the important evidence, and then they just throw it up and don't acknowledge it, and they just keep talking while it's in the background. It's like, if it's the important fucking evidence, acknowledge it and read it to me, dipshit.
Why do they go so damn fucking fast?
In hindsight, this is a pretty shit video, but it was made for people who knew who Harley was and his Discord server's drama in the first place. I stopped paying attention to Kenji since last year, so I don't know what any of the new stuff is, but HappySoft DM'd me about this, so that's why I'm here. That's a fair point.
I will yell at you if you prove me wrong, levels of manipulation. And because she has a big old victim complex, she has to make it hard to call out the villain. So when I called her out for tracing my art multiple times, she's now trying to
shoot back. Why are we going so fucking fast, bro?
The homophobic part doesn't even make sense, considering my boyfriend of the last 2 years is bisexual. Neither does the manipulate kid.
Ponder, do you know when Prim supposedly got involved with the alleged ring? If she was 15/16 in 2018 and was involved around the time, it's incredibly likely that she was groomed, and we may actually be dealing with a victim of grooming rather than a perpetrator. This is a what if, but I thought it was important to bring it up.
Nope, because we don't know that. Actually, it might have been mentioned to me at some point. Let me double check something. Orange, do you happen to know when Prim got into the KVA group? The supposed CP ring. Do we know when Primrose actually got involved with them? What date? What year?
Most of my friends are the same age or older than me, but then again, she's told people that my friends are all manipulated, so I guess it's everyone who disagrees with me is wrong kind of mentality. My last topic will be tracing and character theft allegations against me, which I'm gonna guess is Rose projecting again, since she's known for tracing and theft. She's accusing me of tracing drawings I've posted the sketching process for, and she's made a big list to show how all of my current drawings look different, even though one's from 2018, another one was drawn on a phone, one is mimicking her style, and another one wasn't even a drawing of a human. This whole drama is just Rose trying to stay relevant while trying to frame people she doesn't like. And Rose, if you're watching this, I'm just gonna tell you now, anybody who knows you isn't buying your bullshit. Like, there's archives of you being a manipulative liar for years, so if you better quit or you'll just ruin your already terrible reputation even more. I'm Orange and I'm out.
So listen, I didn't want to make this video, okay? I contacted Cherry on several platforms, and I asked them if we could just put the beef behind us.
I'm already a day into, like, making and editing a video, so I'm not really going to back down. You're the one who wanted the beef in the first... So Cherry just causing shit for the sake of causing shit. Cool.
And I asked them if we could just put the beef behind us, because I warned them... I knew that this video coming out with the stuff in it.
I'm sorry, but anybody who's like, I'm making a video on you, your channel's gonna die. I don't know how Harley reacts to that, but that's like the funniest fucking shit.
And the exposing within the video would quite severely permanently damage. The video will probably show above all her other videos, and whenever she makes a video, all my fans will keep disliking it, which is a thing that I can't control. And I knew that that's what was going to happen if I made the video, and that's why I attempted several times to contact Cherry. I asked her if we could talk, I asked her if we could chill, I asked her if we could just be normal, and she refused.
Harley, you're talking way too slow for me.
So all I'm gonna say, I didn't make any other part of this video, I have no responsibility for it, I don't take any liability, I'm not affiliated with any of the claims made, and everything in this video is allegations, completely allegations, 100% fully allegations, based on evidence, that's how I view it anyway. But what I want to tell you is my experience with Cherry, what happened between me and Cherry. So Cherry Blossom Tree was a moderator on my YouTube Discord.
Oh, well that's not... Wait, how the fuck did Primrose become a moderator?
Moderator since I made some of my own recent videos, everybody found me through that video, and they decided they were going to join my server, and they had arguments with my server, I have screenshots from all of this, and the arguments they had, they started telling people to kill themselves, they started harassing other members, they said some transphobic things and screenshots that I had, and there was some evidence that's all-
Conceptia, you sound like an adult in a child's- There's just people freaking out over a shit-sitter.
Being allegedly involved in some pedophilic actions, which wasn't the main reason I banned them, even though it was a severe reason, which I felt, which is why I emphasized it so much in my video. I emphasized this claim more than anything else because I felt it was the most important thing, even though it's not the main reason she got banned. I still think that it's important that
alleged pedophilia, okay.
Because my audience is quite a large bit of children, even though my majority is 18 to 21 year olds, it's still a big part of my irresponsible to be involved in my family, and that's why I warned them, because if anyone had involvement with her, she could have been a risk to them from the allegations I'd seen. But that wasn't the main reason I banned Cherry, because it's 100% real, and Cherry had 100% done it, which kind of shocked me, and that was the main reason she was banned in the first place. But after that, Cherry then went to two different communities to get me raided, and the other community was this community called the Junta Beta Base, and this is a server where she got the owner to attempt to raid me, and...
Just want to apologize for dragging you out into some crap, dude. We just got told by some guy in our little friend group, hey lol, there's a server to raid. I know, LMAO, it's totally okay, don't worry. LMAO, there's nothing to argue. So yeah, just wanted to let you know that we're sorry. I made it clear my video was allegations, even if the other don't say it.
I was kind of shocked because I didn't really do anything. But they attempted to raid me, and that's basically what happened.
Okay, so essentially this I'm not saying that, is bitch ass. I first met him because he was given unsolicited advertisements for some video he was making because some asshole called him out and he needed a response vid. He was like, blah, 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 blah. Okay, so this cherry tree bitch essentially started a server raid for his server because they were spamming CBT shit. Cock and ball torture?
Oh.
And she was uncomfortable with it, so he ended up making a call out video on her for doing it because they were close at the time. However, his fan base went ham on her and doxed her address, accused her of being a pedophile. But evidence proves that Harley is more. What?
My server almost got raided, but I spoke to the owner of the server and they realized that
I asked you to give me credit in the video and you shoved me to the bottom of the description. Kind of pissed me off. Then you speak to me, you don't go silent and blast me out on raid server. Yeah, that was a mistake of mine. But can you at least see where I'm coming from? Besides, I told mods about that server and got it disbanded before the raid could happen, so I helped you out in the end. Yeah, I'm going around bad-mouthing you and saying that you're probably a pedo, but like, I helped you out in the end, so it's fine, right? Now updated my description. Please talk to me about this stuff, though. Don't really need you calling me a pedo. I was just running off info I've heard from Cherry Tree, who I now realize is a terrible source in hindsight, because she was...
Didn't do anything wrong, and they cancelled the raid, so it never happened. I did get raided the next day by Stardust, the guy that exposed me.
It was literally all I could show without getting age-restricted. They spam porn over my face. Oh, gross.
But, yeah, anyway, I've decided, after all this time, I'm done with Cherry Blossom Tree. I'm going to explain why. After she was banned the first time, I made my video about why, because she'd sent me some models, and the information she'd given behind them wasn't completely true.
Well, say, the issue with all that, too, is just, the word pedophile is just going to lose all meaning.
For my Yandere Dev. Yandere Simulator has Yandere Dev as a loser, 16-year-old. Now, the video information she provided me wasn't 100% true. It wasn't even close to 50% true. And for that reason, I spoke about it, and when I was called out, and someone explained to me that I was wrong, and the information was wrong, I realized, and that was the first strike for Cherry, and the second strike was the raids, and raids are against Discord TOS, so I had no choice but to ban her.
Okay, I understand Harley's thinking to a degree, but also, why would you just randomly take some fucker's word when you're doing research on a video? Like, that seems like the dumbest thing.
He accepts that or not. And then I made my Osana's out video, where I accepted the fact that I was wrong about the models, and I felt it only right to briefly cover the fact that Cherry had allegedly had some involvement with minors that was.
Wait, what? This is across a 15-second segment of the video.
Whether she accepts that or not.
Raid my Discord. Nasty stuff to an 11-year-old.
Allegedly. So I decided that it was important that I would discuss it. I felt it was only right that I kept my audience in the know and protected if they had involvement with her and the allegations were true. It's not like the Basher situation. Basher was called a pedophile. There's no 100% evidence, but it's still important that people knew that Basher had allegedly had involvement, and the same goes for Cherry. So I made the information public, and that's when Cherry, off the rail, she harassed me, saying that I was threatening to call the police on me.
Can you confirm you started a raid against my server? Yes, I unintentionally did out of panic, but it wasn't your newest one. It was a raid of like 3 people when I was still in your server. I had no idea how the newest raid happened, which was after my ban. Okay, can you now confirm you threatened to call the police against me and sue me? I threatened to call the police and sue you just so you would talk to me for the first time because I didn't want to deal with the shitty drama. But you made those threats, not warning me that they were jokes. I didn't know that they were not serious until 2 days ago. You can confirm that, right? Okay, so the second thing that Kurumi Batwing sent me was this Twitter thread, which is between the person HappySoft that made like the original DA stash that they sent and Kenji Primrose. The horrid DMs I got from @PrimroseDraws on Instagram on their account Lavberg, which is now deleted. I have a mutual who will be posting these on Instagram for me as well. The ones being posted here are the uncensored ones because fuck it. People need to know how horrid he is. They DM'd me and did this shit because I made a post talking about the shady shit he's done. I would like to make note that Happy indicates here that this is in response to a post that Happy made on Instagram. We don't get to see that post here. We are just seeing Klavberg's response to it. We're already going in from a bad standpoint because we don't get to see the thing that spurred this conversation. So Lamberg says, hey, the joint account is owned by 3 different people. Each person has their own separate account that they can link off of it. One of the admins even contacted you through that account, and you responded with, hi Quill, so why do you believe I have access to Rainbow Lullaby? We're already seeing from the response that fucking HappySoft was making accusations in the post, and Schlafberg here is responding to those accusations. The fact that we can't see the original post, context is sexy. Give me all the context. Sorry, I was reading ahead. We already know that Happy is, like, making additional accusations. But then Primrose is all, second of all, no, me and exposing Milky, Space Milk Milky, are not the same person. The only 3 accounts I have linked to Instagram are this one, my abandoned main account, and my abandoned secondary account. And HappySoft responds with, I said DM me if you have sufficient proof, lol. I didn't say come in my DMs to whine. I'm sorry, sufficient proof that he is not the users you're claiming he is? That's not how that works. That's asking to prove a negative.
Didn't they just give you what you wanted?
Already we're like, one, we're being introduced to this from like an improper point because we're not given the full context as to the original post that spurred this fucking conversation. We can also see that Happy is asking the person they've just accused of something to now provide proof that they are not a thing, which is proving a negative, which isn't how any of this works. You can't ask someone to prove a fucking negative. And I didn't inform you that you can be a two-faced, snot-nosed cow and continue to consistently lie about me and what I own, did I? But you still did that, sunshine. Snap. Yes, this one's going in my cringe compilation. You took a pic of yourself? Cool. Took you 8 minutes to come up with that one? Nah, I was busy talking to a friend. I saw when you saw the message. My bad, 5 minutes. Yeah, I was busy, you know. And I didn't inform you that you can be a two-faced snot. Damn, you're not just unoriginal with art, but comebacks too. Damn, must suck. Like you did to your dad's remember when you had a panic attack when I quote unquote stole from you, but then turned around and stole from me? Poggers, bro. Oh, nice. Incest and rape jokes? Not rape if you consented to it. I'm literally 15 and a victim. Why are you saying this to people who are literally trying to piss you off? Oh my god, children, stop revealing your entire fucking personal lives to trolls. They're obviously gonna use it against you. I'm literally 15 and a victim of probably sexual assault. You should really try and work that tiny peanut-sized brain of yours sometime. Sorry, I thought you were 5. Also, remember when you had a panic attack when I stole from you? Even though you stole from me? Pog. Said that 2 seconds ago, lol. Obviously, he's trying to get you to acknowledge it then. Cool, but remember it? Also, I never claimed you stole from me, sweaty. But keep being delusional, it's funny, lol. I'll admit, I redesigned your OC for shits and giggles, and I was in the wrong, but you're not any better. Cool, that's poggers, bro. Also, remember when you had a panic attack when I quote unquote. Can you stop talking like the basement-dwelling Redditor you are for like a sec? How can you stop talking like the thing that he is? Oh, so you did steal from me? Thanks for the evidence. Dog, I took the post down ages ago, LMFAO. It was last year, and I admit to my past mistakes, unlike you. Wow. So, yeah, he's just gonna keep ragging on that now, because now you've given him something to go for. Me and Quill are dying. I'm screaming this. XD. So am I. You aren't special. Is that for real? You had a panic attack because someone stole from you? There are some instances where, like, people should not be fucking online. Like, if you're that sensitive, you shouldn't be online. If, like, somebody stealing your artwork is gonna be that much of a trigger, and it's someone who's stealing your artwork because they're a fucking troll and they're deliberately trying to get on your nerves, you're not gonna survive in online spaces. Oi, oi, Benchode. Sorry, I'm talking to my boyfriend because someone actually loves me. Sorry. I also hate that you can't see, like, the duration for when any of this conversation was taking place. You only know, like, when it was screenshotted. LMAO, you have a boyfriend? Thought he was dead. Do you have anything other than the same 2 jokes or not? Yeah, you're adopted. LOL, get wrecked. Remember when you had a panic attack? Lol, bitch, bye. Ah, scared? Blocking me, huh? Too bad. Crying, crying, crying. Did Whittle Kajigas God? You're bitching about the troll going after you and, like, harassing you and shit, but then you're constantly, like, doing this shit? You're provoking the troll. So, Quill wanted me to show you their new OC. LMFAO, thanks for more proof, dude. It's my old art anyways, so I don't really care. So, yeah, this is, I guess, Happy Soft's OC. It's my old art anyway, so I don't really care. LMFAO, you don't make me upset. Everybody knows that's not what you guys' shitty art looks like, so they'll know it's Trace, don't worry, ooh woo. I mean, if the art is shitty in that pic, it's because of you, not Quill, but go off, sunshine. I mean, you guys aren't when you don't trace little Mr. Brain Dead. Keep in mind, all my work actually is protected by copyright, and I'll gladly file a DMCA, ooh woo. Yeah, trolls don't care about your copyright. All of my OCs are protected by copyright, blah blah blah. But you and your little friend still stole from me and changed them up so I can gladly DMCA claim again, especially since you admitted to stealing from me. Actually, I took down the post, so legally I'm not accountable anymore, but nice try. Not how that would technically work. You can't DMCA someone if they took down the offending material, that is true. Especially since said material is from last year. I could still legally take you to court for theft. I have the evidence. Nope. So does the police officer I'm working with. Ooh, someone made a character on the internet close to yours as a joke. Ooh, I'm not fucking scared of you, but nice try, LOL. Just keep giving me more DMs of yours to post. Keep digging your own grave. It's funny. You know what's funny? Remember when you had this guy really only has one thing. This is why you don't reveal your private shit to, like, trolls, because they will just constantly berate you with it. Ah, the same joke from last night? Cute. Oh, so now this is a whole ass other day? Great. I love not having the fucking dates and times. You realize you're your words really don't get to me, right? Then why are you fucking responding every time he brings it up? Oh my god, if it wasn't getting to you, you wouldn't keep saying it wasn't getting to you. You're like talking to a toddler. I genuinely do not care what the fuck you say to me, lol, it's not gonna hurt me. Remember when you got that? That shit funny too. You're really bad at forming arguments, huh? And, thanks for calling me a cutie. Love you too, baby. Oh, also, you asked me for proof of me being autistic, right? So where's your proof that you're a... He's got a point. I didn't say you were cute. Come on, Sunshine, hand it over. Also, no, I didn't ask for that, so try again. You did, so hand it over. Don't believe you. You're lying about, wow, you're really a piece of shit. Yep, I'm not a mirror, though. Sorry. Literally, medically have PTSD, LMFAO. Oh my god, you're... Sure, just give him another thing to use against you. I'm not sending you my medical papers. You don't have the rights to see that. Then you're lying. What the fuck? Why are you lying about that and PTSD? The fuck? So then you're lying about autism too, huh? Your point makes no fucking sense. You asked me for proof. I used the same excuse and got called a liar. Again, I know you're trying to bother me, but it isn't working. This shit is- I never asked you for that, but okay, go off. Go get blanked by your dad again. Not responding, too busy being that by your dad? What a shame. Your mom's loose cunt wasn't enough, huh? I have actual good art to draw, dog. The fact that, like, she didn't respond, and he got upset that she didn't respond, so he tried to prompt her again, and then she did respond. It's so obvious he's trying to get on her nerves, and it's working. Sorry, I'm reading even further, and, like, she's still goading this guy on. You're pissy at the troll, but every time you talk to the troll, you goad them on. You think your art is good. As well as a sister was just talking to me. Unlike you, I don't sit on my ass all day and cry like a bitch. Keyboard smash. I can't breathe. Nah, but it's good compared to yours, LMFAO. Can't fucking breathe. Oh my god. Your sister get butt fucked too? Okay, show your recent art piece then, and we'll critique each other. She's 10, you fucking nonce, and add on to the proof that I'm a nonce for not knowing your sister's age and making a joke about your shitty lies about that, Pog. He's kind of right, not about the lies about the sexual assault, but like he's right about that's not what a fucking nonce is, and that's not how you determine if someone's a pedophile. Literally don't mention family members to a troll or predator, what the heck. Yeah, exactly. I think that's supposed to be then maybe don't talk about someone being raped, you actual brain dead piece of shit, or just keep talking. The shit is funny and you're just giving me more evidence. This is literally just you being fucking trolled. None of this is evidence. You're 17, don't you have better things to do? Like, deadass, genuine question. So confirmed, they were 17 at this time. Not even a legal adult, according to the person in the screenshot. Like my new art piece, it's called Nonce and a Clown. My boyfriend is literally only a year older than me, no need to drag him into it because you're sad and lonely. Also nice photo editing, this probably took you like, what, 10 seconds? I'm so offended. He's a nonce, your boyfriend is a nonce, you're a drama queen who lies about her own rape and PTSD, and I feel bad for your sister and hope she's adopted into a better home, not full of clowns. Anyhow, you've given me enough evidence for now. Oh, has he? Has he really? And since you dragged my boyfriend into it, you're even more fucked than you already were. Thanks for all the evidence of you being a scumbag. I'm gonna move to general DMs because having to listen to you talk is depleting my brain cells. Have fun having your life ruined by your own actions. I literally have a police officer going through 4 years of evidence against you and your friends, so good luck being a cum slut in jail, whore. Bye. They have done other horrid things as well. I suggest Harley TBS's video as proof that they have been doing shit like this to people for years and haven't matured at all. Well, we looked at Harley's video and it was mostly focused around one situation that did not at all involve all the other shit, so it doesn't fucking matter. All right, Kuromi, what else you got for me? Okay, so this is the next thing they sent me. He has a new alt on Instagram. Let me know if you recognize the designs. So just keeping up with him because he traces your characters. I don't care. Okay, so what else we got? Call out post for Tea Toxic and Primrose Draws. This is from October 16th, 2021. Primrose is a known art thief, tracer, doxer, and groomer. Literally, who gives a shit about all the former crap if grooming is in there? I don't care if someone traced your art. So they have doxed Blood Orange's partner and made CP. I have proof. The doxing situation, and I will provide proof. I've just looked to the side and I saw that the person providing proof is 14. I don't have high hopes, guys. These people happen to be obsessive and they're friends. I think it was pretty dumb to dox someone just because they didn't accept your confession, which happened to be the reason Obsessive did this. Oh, these are the ones that we saw from Harley's fucking video. They were 15. I don't care. The whole CP thing. Before I show all the evidence, one, it would be terrifying if they actually showed evidence of CP. Here's a list of their alt. Primrose Draws, Primrose Draws XX, Obsessed Diamond. Oh, okay, that's how we know Obsessive. Sand Squabble, Cassie the Dragon. That sounds familiar. Dolly Duff. Foxu, Free Adopts, Harpin Struggles, Art Police, Lav Not Safe for Work, Great Griffin X. Well, we already know they're missing some things, because according to Happy Soft, Klavberg was also one of them. And what about Fruity Loop Milk? Cassie the Dragon posts on Twitter, my, she takes it up both holes, what a horror. So the screenshot you sent me of the- this isn't CP. Factually, it's not CP. It's not how CP works. If this is your evidence that they drew CP, you have zero fucking evidence! Yes, it's gross to make porn of a minor's character, but that's not what fucking CP is. It's such a fucking clusterfuck. I think it's honestly disgusting to do any minor, no matter the reason. The stuff is sick. Being a troll, I don't think he really cares. Another thing we have on this list is tracing from Milk Puppy. I don't fucking care. This is really pointless to do. Making an account just to trace people you dislike is a very immature thing. It's almost like he's a troll. Accusing Kiwi. Milk Puppy of CP. So Kiwi has never done anything like this. That's not what she- So this is a post by Obsessive Diamond. Report this person for harassment, supporting the spread of child pornography, supporting targeted harassment, supporting a doxer. So Milky Kiwi, that's not what she showed me. She showed me so much more. Incropped, uncropped. You're getting taken down so fast, hun. You can kiss your account goodbye. Was there something else? How old are the OCs you draw Not Safe for Work off again? XD over 18. But you draw them to look like a child. Not really. I don't think a child would have gigantic tits. They look like children. Okay, so this is just dumbass arguments we've seen before. Troll being a troll. Multiple people are blind then. If they think they are children, then yes, sad. Don't send me kissing emojis, you fucking- oh. Also, I can take you to court and argue you draw child pornography since in my country. If you draw a picture and multiple people believe it depicts a child, you can be taken- No! It's if the layman can reasonably look at the image and view it as a child, not some random fucking group of trolls who all get together and like, yep, we've decided this is a child. With your CP drawing, it's of another person, not your OC, meaning they will ask that other person if it's underage, these are my OCs. Yeah, but that doesn't matter if somebody else draws your character and they intend for your character to be above age. It doesn't fucking matter what the canon age is if they intend to draw the character older. Sorry, that's not how that works. Again, you can't do anything, neither can you. Plus, there is proof of her saying the characters that are in Not Safe for Work that she draws are underage. Oh, there you go. Also, there was one where she was accused of tracing, which is pure utter shit. What the fuck is this? She has pics of my friends' faces and shit saved. Okay, those are faces and arms. You didn't label the nudes. And a folder says IRL info, which includes someone who did some not so nice things to my body, pick some- Oh, of course, and it doesn't continue. Why are we getting snippets of the whole conversation? Then what's this? Her own original artwork. That doesn't prove she traced. You just said there's proof of them claiming the characters are underage. I would expect that proof to be in the tweet talking about it, saying there's proof. So we just don't get it, okay. Overall, this person has traced people with no credit, has drawn child porn of minors- that's not what child porn is- doxed someone, and has just been a huge douchebag in general. Well, yeah, he's a troll. Exactly what I expect. Google Doc 2. Confessions of Primrose. More Kenji shit. Oh my god, there's so much. Potential doxing. Sorry, someone lives at a shopping center? Yep, that's still not child porn. You literally just got done talking about how you think they made child porn. I don't fucking care if they traced. Is this just the same shit over again? I've already gone over this. Considering these guys are accusing him of making child porn and they're just as fucking wrong. So far, all I'm getting from this is that this person was a dick and a troll, not a groomer slash pedo. Yeah, basically. You could maybe say the doxing. Sure, I don't know how accurate the doxing is, because like I can't read half of this shit. Again, that makes me question who the Just Eric is. Obviously, the claims about them having made CP are fucking wrong. Obviously, their claims of Blood Orange making CP are fucking wrong. I adore how this whole thing began with a claim that they were a part of a CP ring. Guess what has yet to come up? Yeah, exactly! If they're a part of a CP ring, why is the CP not CP? Is that everything? Is that literally just a Google Doc going over the shit that we already fucking went over? Okay, fuck you. What a waste of my time. Okay, second Google Doc. Proof the CP account belongs to them. Here is a screenshot of the same post that was made on Fuck Off. It's not CP. Next. Dumb, dumb. Google Doc 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Stop. Evidence. Proof of dating a minor and watching child porn. Now we get completely new accusations. Primrose Draws says, I have actual real nudes on my iPad. XD. Eric the person. Never mind dark web. Actually, it's easy to find porn of a 15-year-old. Not in America. You get the feds in America. 15 to 20, it's quite easy, especially 16. I can use a VPN on my iPad to access it. It's classes as something location in another country. I don't like that that's covered. Okay, 11-year-old that showed me her tits in call and spread. I was molesting her. I was falsely accused of being a pedo because I dated an 11-year-old for 2 hours. To start, individual cropped out Discord screenshots like this, where you can't see the whole conversation, much less who the fucking account owner is. Not evidence. Doesn't prove jack and shit. Where's the context? 2, just because someone says that they have a thing, you still have to prove that they have it. This is not proof that someone has child porn. That's not how any of this works. Now we're at they dated a minor and also they own CP. Toonie Star Child talking to Cherry Blossom Tree, which we know is Primrose, apparently. Lol, you still trace, I see. Is that correct? It's called tracing not safe for work porn as a joke off of a tracer. People did it to Cristalli. I could do it too. But the character he drew was a minor, and that character you drew is also a minor, right? You could literally draw this and say, hey, the character is 18, and you're fine. Proof of drawing fan art of Valdrox's OC, Sapphiro. That's an offense now? They drew fan art for the wrong predator. To be fair, yeah, you probably shouldn't be drawing fan art for Cristalli, but like, when did this happen? This isn't dated. This happened in 2018, so he either just turned 15 or he is 14. This is why dates are fucking important. Proof of stealing an OC and making her a prostitute. This is proof of stealing an OC. Obsessive Diamond, a little redesign of a prostitute bunny made by Harp and Snuggles. So they're like, hey, I took this character by this artist and I redesigned it. And you're like, hey, that's proof they stole the character. I'd like to see the original. Okay, where do I begin? You dated an 11-year-old for a couple of... When was this made? The first thing that pops into my mind is why. Why only a couple of hours? Were they dating the 11-year-old only for a couple of hours because they didn't know they were an 11-year-old? What's the context? You claim to be 17, but you've lied more than once, plus people claim that you're actually 18/19 while you're in the UK. People claim! Who the fuck are people? You're putting yourself in a whole lot of trouble and karma is going to catch up to you, boo. Next, if you really wanted to make Jote not safe for worse and trace off Nora, you at least could have chosen an of-age character. Doesn't matter what the character's canon age is, it could literally just be any age you decide it is. Look, watch this, fuckers. This character's 12! Now he's getting railed. Except now in this drawing, he's 34. Prove me wrong! Y'all, stop claiming something as CP if you can't actually be arsed to go look up what the fucking legal definition of CP is.
I guess the Cristalli fan art is a joke too, because that's your excuse for making that shit most of the time.
Someone's allowed to make Cristalli fan art and say that it's a joke. Finally stealing a character and making her a prostitute? What the actual fuck is wrong with you, sis? Yes, 16 can be the age of consent in places like Sweden and Japan, and I get you're sad you're said to be in the United Kingdom, but just why? If you're 16, you're usually in high school over here in the US. I feel the need to note that you can have 16-year-old sex workers. It sucks, and it's awful, and it shouldn't happen, but it does. If someone was like, hey, I'm making this 16-year-old character and they're a prostitute, as long as they don't draw any porn of something that is deliberately supposed to look like a 16-year-old, who fucking cares? It's a character. Like, shit like that exists in real life. Sorry, guys. Why do people always bring up Japan in these conversations? Nearly all Japanese prefectures do not use the federal minimum and do 18 instead. Well, that's because people don't fucking understand. Age of consent is 16 here in the UK, if anyone wanted to know. Well, there you go. In conclusion, Diamond isn't one to be trusted. I mean, I could agree with that, at least. They're a wolf in sheep's clothing for some, and even if it's only some too many. Thank you for checking this doc out. Bye. Go fuck yourself. Diamond/Primrose admitted to never meaning the apology in the video and confessed to only doing the video to earn sympathy and forgiveness from people willing to forgive her and didn't mean any of it. She admits to only doing this to defend her own case. Oh, I gotta read this fucking shit. Obsessed Lavender is Primrose. She has this. The profile picture is a naked, what looks to be a child with bruises and blood on them and bite marks. It's a drawing! Am I supposed to be able to fucking read these? There's also stuff like this. Uncensored, which again look like children. Toxic tea. Oh my fucking god, this is for Goretober. So exposing milk. Wait. I found it. Happy Soft's post, according to this, made implications that Klavberg, or Primrose, or Obsessed, or Kenji, or whatever the fuck they want to call him, was also running an account called Exposing Milky. Now, we are seeing that Obsessed Lavender is supposed to be fucking Kenji slash Primrose, and they are talking to Exposed Milky. Is this supposed to implicate that Happy Soft was wrong? Whoever the hell this Exposing Milky person actually is, says, she does seem to make them look a lot like children with regards to toxic tea. That could literally just be how tea draws. Yeah, I heard you made an apology video to her and other people. Did you actually mean it? Like, was it a serious thing? I'm only asking because it would be totally confusing if it was, considering all the nasty shit she's done to you. I didn't really mean it. I only said it because she slandered me as a pedophile. Good, she didn't deserve any apology. Told me I deserve my cunt filled with cement. Hope your parents are happy of their pedo daughter. I don't believe that instantly because we haven't seen screenshots of it. Really, that's fucking awful. Yeah, I don't care. They called her a pedophile. If she apologizes and doesn't mean it for that reason because they called her a fucking pedophile and that's the only reason she did it, I don't care. Oh, she only apologized because we called her a pedophile. Yeah, no duh, bitch. Her adopts are also very suspicious, blah, blah, blah. Oh, also, sorry for the not safe for gross. Include stuff like this. Isn't that a commission? Yes, me and my friend believe the picture is traced. From what? They steal vent characters and turn them into disgusting clowns and stuff. They all have a hate grip chat against me, and they stole my vent persona and redesigned her. When I came out with the evidence against them proving they did it, they told me I photoshopped the evidence and that I was a liar, so people attacked me. They are so shitty. When I post this, they're gonna be attacking them, not you. Hang on. Here's all the accounts that are helping in the harassment of Primrose Draws. They are not associated with the people that are collecting actual evidence of Prim's BS. They're people that are negatively impacting everyone. Can I just say Prim stopped the BS and they're falsely accusing her of pedophilia and slandering her? I don't know if Prim stopped the BS, but they're right that they are incorrect in their accusations so far. None of the accusations I've seen have been correct. People can steal art. It's like a normal thing to do. Who is even... So this is a conversation between someone and someone named Shy Shy Race. Caught you, bitch. They were posted on the same exact day. And... it's obviously theirs. I'm adding this to the proof for my video. I've had cases where people steal from others on the same day and try to play it off as original when we can tell the times they post. Just because something is posted the same day again does not mean it isn't stolen. Blah, blah, blah. Whatever. This shit is dumb. I don't know what the fuck this is supposed to say. Also this, she's so dumb, like that doesn't really prove it's you. I heard you also came to an agreement with Milky. What was the agreement? We didn't. The art account had to do it for Milky, but it was that Milky took down her video about me and stopped slandering me and I'd put up an apology video. Oh, so is the agreement still going on? I don't know. She didn't take it down, so. App fair. Do you want to end the drama with her or do you plan to still keep an eye on the shitty things she's done? Like, do you plan on still watching her or are you just gonna leave her alone? Watching her. Good, she tends to turn her back on people a lot and spread false info. Like how she spread I was a pedophile. Are you ever planning to take the apology video down since she probably isn't paying attention to it? And yes, exactly like that. Probably. And then another screenshot that is like cut off. Something, something. The victim messaged you and you blocked the victim. No, I want to prove her and Orange made up. So this is that Shy Shy person again. Victim even offered to message you for Prim. I don't care. You're getting arrested. End of story. I hope your parents are proud of their little pedo daughter. Bye. Oh, there you go. That's the person who was all like, I hope your parents are proud of their little pedo daughter. I literally cannot see how they think she's good here. Like, this is harassment and bullying on the highest fucking level. So first pick is more evidence of the stolen OC. Second pick is more harassment. Third pick is an onlooker admitting that a 12-year-old nudes were spread, as well as her self-harm images, that 12-year-old being me, and then Milky using said images against me. When I was 12, I had my naked body photographed and spread around. Milky has seen people spread it, but I'm gonna put a pin in that for now, because that's the first we've heard of that. Why the fuck are we now hearing claims that Primrose is a victim? Apparently, Milky has seen my naked body and also my self-harm scars, but used a falsified evidence of my ex made evidence against me to call me a pedophile, even though my ex spread read my nudes and stuff. Okay, so this is the claim of Primrose claiming her ex sent nudes. Yeah, obviously we haven't seen proof of that. She has also seen my self-harm scars but called them fake. I'd like to see that. That's it. The confession of Primrose was literally just, oh yeah, I didn't mean my apology because they called me a pedophile. My conversation with Diamond Primrose. Bitch, who is you? So you're the exposing milky person that what's-her-face thought was Primrose? I can't. More Kenji shit. Boba Melon Tea. Base by nobody uses my art as literal bases. Motherfucker better not be trying to say this is traced. Fine, we'll do it. We'll play your fucking game. It's the titties and the hips. It's not even the hips. Oh my god, they don't even fucking match. I'm gonna scream. And I think we all know these ones are flat out not the same fucking piece. This one's at least a little closer. It's not traced. What are these supposed to be showing? Is this supposed to be, like, proof that someone's stealing characters? Oh, that's it? That's where it ends? Okay. More Primrose shit. Oh my god, they started it with hello. If your call-out document starts with hello, you're too young for this shit. This doc is gonna be about more drama with Primrose. When was this document made? February 7th, 2021. We were recently being friends until one day they decided to make the account Mellow Doodles Hose. They do change their username a lot. I will keep you guys updated on the username changes, which is an account that steals art of other artists. So, a conversation with Primrose draws. Whoever the fuck this other person says. No, your significant other already says it was you, so don't try to act dumb. You know what you're doing. There's plenty of evidence of the account being you. I'm not dumb. You of all people should know that. Actually, there's 4 people inside the account. It's a joint account. Even so, you're one of them. I've only posted, like, 1 pic here. There's multiple there in your style. Here's some of my own art / OSTs that they have stolen / traced. Mellow Doodles Hose. Yeah, that looks like Primrose. I mean, they've made some changes, but fair. Now you may be asking, how is this traced? Well, this is traced from a few of my other art pieces. The hair itself was traced from my art above. No, that's not traced. First, pay attention to ears. One is traced from this exact image. The other puppy ear and arms are traced from this image. No, that's also not traced. It's just copied. The other one of my OCs that were heavily referenced from was this, which used to be on my old Toxic Tea account. Wait, so you're Toxic Tea? I thought Toxic Tea was a bad person. My design for Nymphy Poopies contest. Did they give it bacon wings? They have also tried to copy my Hot Cheeto adopt. Not only do they copy my art, they also got their significant other, aka boyfriend/girlfriend, to harass me on multiple of my accounts, as well as using the R slur and slit shaming. When I block them, they do it through another account. These are screenshots taken from my story on Instagram. I'm scrolling through the thing, and they were like, oh, he tried to ask her for her medical records, which is illegal.
That's not no, illegal.
No, it's not.
It's a violation of doctors to talk about your medical records without your permission.
I assume this is proof of them stealing from other artists because it's like, it's got a watermark, and I assume that's a watermark from another artist. Which, again, we understand they're stealing and tracing art. They're a fucking troll. They're trying to piss you off. I don't care. Yes, he's being a bitch. He's mocking her sexual assault. This is more bullshit. Here are some more aliases of this individual. Also, what the fuck is up with Cristalli fan art? Oh my god! You can't cancel someone because they made fan art for the wrong person. I think we've gone over this well enough. They can't prove that this is a fucking CP ring. They clearly don't seem to understand what CP constitutes. Okay, so I click on the death threats folder, and I'm like, okay, so it has to have death threats in it, right? There's another folder in it called Hating Women. Supposedly, this is just Primrose being all like, hey, I don't like ladies. I like that so much of this is, like, clearly stuff that Primrose is quoting from something else, but we don't get to see the full fucking context of it. And this is a vent chat! Girls hurt me physically and mentally, and they love to steal boys away. They were cheating, manipulative, slutty scumbags. That's why I hate them. If murder was legal, she would be first, not gonna lie. Just being a fucking edgy bitch. I don't see how that's death threats. Cherry Blossom is Primrose. The fuck no. Cam girls are fucking whores. If I could be Hitler for the day, I'd take all the whores out. How old are they? When's the date? I'm pissed off as it is. I'm not fucking targeting Orange, but in my eyes, she can fucking die for all I care. Along with Lily and all of her stupid fucking friends sticking up for some dumb freak who thinks it's okay to spread pictures of me naked, draw disgusting pictures of me, trace me, stalk me, bully me. When did she trace you? Who, Lily? I love how it just completely cuts off the rest of the conversation. You don't get to know anything else! Well, we've seen the alleged doxing things when she was like 15. Doxing herself? What are these? Can we all acknowledge that this is fucking titled Doxing Herself? Why is this relevant? Doxing Menace. Yes, again, we know this happened when she was 15. Eric doxing her. I thought you said that was a false thing. Yeah, cool, thanks for lying. Secondly, you spread pics of me in my underwear around. Why do you think I hate Nadir? Since they spread Primrose draws. I've been constantly attacked and called names, and they have access to, yeah, change that. But they also have seen pics of me in my underwear. So basically, two people, Fox and Eric, are threatening to spread personal information about her. Yeah, this is all, like, cropped to such a degree that, like, I can't do anything with it. Yes, and playing victim, causing drama, sending a picture to yourself in your underwear to Eric, lying, saying death threats, then getting mad when people do that to you, etc. It's all on Instagram, Discord, and Twitter. I don't care if you say that's old, you shouldn't have- What the fuck? Gross. Wait, I'm sorry. So, like, she sent her own pics? No, that showcases her sending it to Eric in possibly 2018 when she was 15. But I thought she lied about the picture. It's been claimed that she lied about people spreading her nudes. But now there is an actual nude that someone was fucking spreading? Or is she lying about it here? Threatening to sue someone, not in the drama. Oh no, they threatened to- I don't fucking care.
Ever since Randy Stare, I feel like everybody's just been trigger happy to find that next person.
I want to be the next person to expose, blah, blah, blah. But, like, people very rarely remember the exposers.
People don't remember Keemstar for being the person who exposed X, Y, and Z. People remember Keemstar for forcing his foot into every single fucking drama, no matter what it fucking was.
I remember Keemstar for falsely claiming that an old man playing RuneScape was a pedophile and sending a whole bunch of hate towards the poor guy.
Racism! That's a new one!
Coronavirus is bullshit, Ilmeo. We make this joke to Kana all the time because he's Chinese and his name sounds like the start of Corona. It's pretty fucking funny.
Oh no! This N called AJ Loser Star is saying he is me and quoting shit from me and saying he's gonna kill his girlfriend if she leaves him. What the fuck is wrong with people? Motherfucker done used my dead body quote. I'm just overprotective over Harley can't fuck a dead body. That's just wrong. How is this racism? I was about to say something, but it would have offended Breeze. Acting like everyone has to be happy-go-lucky so nobody's offended. I swear a lot, use a lot of swears, so get over it. Slurs. That's how I am. You're saying it's okay to hurt people's feelings? No. You had a go at me for saying the word N, which is a slur, so the point is invalid, to be fair. Yeah! King of Stars sort of has a point. I don't see how that's relevant. Oh, white equals good, bad equals black. Oh no. When you get called a racist because of a siren's dark orange skin color and orange palette. Left, the two pics at the top left show the original two forms I planned, as well as the original dress, which is meant to be kelp. What is this? So I took a couple pieces of the story I've drawn and I've decided to draw them. First slide is Rose on the surface. Second slide is corrupt Rose. Oh, regular Rose, and then she's corrupted. Yeah, that's maybe a little iffy. Yeah, let's just have the white half be angels and the dark half be demons. I'm surprised that's the first instance we've heard anything of that. Soda argument. Vent chat. By Soda Kazuichi. Kazuichi Soda! Stop with the shitty excuses, you brought it up while talking about me. You are one, ugly, and two, a bitch. So font be offended by I think that's supposed to be don't be offended by straight up facts. I'm not harassing you on this account. If I was, I would have done much worse. From Lavenikin. Actually, I brought it up after Cloudship asked if I said I didn't like girls. I expanded on what I meant by previously stated I didn't like / talk to girls. What does this have to do with anything? Primrose is Lavenikin. The reason it was stupid was because I made a stupid petty comment about you being in love with me because you won't leave me alone. One, grow the fuck up. Two, act your fucking age. One, I will on my next birthday. And two, we have the same age, sweetheart. I'd rather shag a dog than your ugly mug. I wouldn't want to fuck you anyway, your pussy looks like a washed up fucking trampy hobo. Your legs are like a fucking Tesco too, open 24/7. No, it's just some dumb washed up cunt being R-worded again. So it is. Welp, see ya. I have a penis and I wash every day, unlike you. Can you even clean your body through all your Greg's rolls? So you telling me you've climbed into my bathroom every day and watched my shower just to see if I watch every day? Fucking creep. Pfft, I don't need to see. Your 70 stone nudes was enough. 70 stone nudes? Legit,
shit, you're bigger than my grandma. When people saw your nudes, they were like, damn, the fucking earthquakes are coming. What can I say? I like having a big ass, I can flaunt. I'm sorry, so is this supposed to be confirmation that Primrose has fucking nudes running around somewhere? Because all I'm seeing from this is, like, potential confirmation that, yes, somebody else has seen these fucking nudes, so they must fucking exist. I thought that Primrose was lying about her nudes being leaked. But there are? Hey, at least I didn't look like a washed-up tramp, and at least my personality is as flat as your chest. So, for one, if you look at my account, you can see I'm clean and well-dressed, and two, I'm a man. I have no chest, and your ass isn't a cute big. It's the this bitch is obese and needs a diet big, aka not cute. I mean, you would know about cute ass considering your dad fucks yours every night, but you know. Wow, Primrose, you just fall back on that one all the time. My dad is dead! Just because your clean dress doesn't mean you don't look like a washed up tramp, you fucking nuts. Oh, cool, you're into necrophilia! It's like other people more mature, and you are the one who tried to force sex on a minor. Bitch, where? So go off. And to be honest, I'm personally not into necrophiloa. You know someone who is? But because of how ugly you are, I'm not surprised if that's all the dick you get. You got evidence I tried to force sex on a minor, or are you just saying it because someone else said it? Primrose saying the thing we're all thinking. Goddamn. The video is on YouTube, hun. It's clear you made the person uncomfortable, so go off. That's not what that- Can't fake evidence. Ah, so you can't show evidence. Cool. Well, go back to digging your dead dad up and fucking him, I guess. Prim, you went too far mentioning their dead dad. That's fucked up and makes you look like a horrible person. I mean, I feel like all of y'all are not that great here. They went too far by literally calling me fat, obese, and bullying me just to get a you mentioned their dead dad. Yeah, right? To be fair, I would like to bring up that Primrose did not start off with the dead dad. Primrose made a haha, your dad raped you joke, and then the other person was like, my dad is dead. Primrose didn't bring up the dead dad. Primrose brought up living dad, and then it got turned into dead dad, and then Primrose ran with it. Still not fucking great. And I'm lividly pissed off. I don't care about their dead dad. It's very low to go and insult someone's family when you ran out of arguments. At least they left. Just cause they called you fat, I get called names. Fuck off, ugly bitch. I didn't mention a fucking dead family, or I don't mention a fucking dead family member. You're so immature. Thanks, baby. Love you too. Are you really gonna do that now? Like, how old is she here? Like, when is this from? Can't be ours to tell me how old she is. I don't care. Transphobia. Yeah, I'm pretty sure she said the T word earlier, so I think we can just acknowledge that. Thank you for the stream, everybody. Have yourselves a good night.